100% Chelsea, Liverpool 2, Chelsea 0, expected, to be honest. I was only rubbing it in the face of Liverpool fans because it was funny, but now it's kind of backfired. Mo Salah scored a great goal, to be fair to him. Great player today. The first one.
He's always going to fucking do that, weren't he, yeah. After the stuff on Friday. Well, Thursday, actually. That's the problem. I felt we thought as soon as we saw those videos go up, Salah's going to score a banger against us or have some mad game and score a hat trick. And it happened again. It's the same old predictable bullshit that we've seen every away game this year, bar Fulham and maybe Cardiff. I mean, first off, by our standards, we were okay. I'm not going to say we had a good first half because I don't think we did. I think we had an all right one. But I think the problem today was in-game management, and Sarri has to take some of the blame today. I kind of understood playing a false nine because I thought, okay, at least a little bit it's a bit of an experiment. But 5-10 minutes going in and you could already see the same problems that we always see whenever we play a false nine. No focal points, we get pushed out to the wings because they know we can't cross to anybody. And it just happened all the way through the first half. We kept turning the ball over. And because of that, Liverpool had a lot more chances in that first half. We should have changed it and put a striker on at halftime. But we didn't. And our problem is, so many games we don't react before going down. We react when the goal goes in. And that was the problem today. After we went 1-0, or I think 2-0, it was after one of the goals, then we decided to bring on a striker. And then we brought on Higuain. Higuain or Giroud? Now that's an argument. So that's a bit of an argument.
Is it an argument?
Not anymore. Before then, it was a bit of an argument because also Giroud had played the full 90 on Thursday, so I kind of understood playing Higuain. But he's got a dip, man. He's shit. I'm sorry. I was trying to defend Mo the last couple of games. You could say, yeah, maybe he doesn't get the service. He don't fucking move though. How many times we brought him on for goals? That's why you bring a striker on in the fucking first place.
When he tried to square it to him. Sorry, mate. Cheers. It's when he tried to square it to him. I lost my mind.
I didn't get it. If you're brought on as a striker, your first job is to score goals. If you are one-on-one with the goalkeeper, why are you looking right for an option? It's the fucking mentality in this team, man. We gave up as soon as the second goal went in. And the final 30 minutes of the game just dragged on. And it's the same problem that we always fall into every season. We don't take our chances because we did have chances. But it's the same bollocks that we never fucking take them. Hazard unlucky to hit the post. But let's be real, how many times have we hit the post this season?
We relied on Hazard too much. Therein is the issue. I mean, yep. I was like, he hit the post twice. Yeah, okay. That was unlucky. The goal looked like it was coming. It didn't come. That is football.
Is it football if that happens every fucking game to us? Is it? If there's a pattern of that, then I don't think it's more than football. It's the players. Willian's end product is dog shit. Hudson-Odoi's in development. Eden Hazard's the only player that's really doing anything. Giroud's slow, but at least he can link up play. And fucking Pedro is past it. Our attack is dead. And then what we did after that was, instead of trying to improve the attack, we brought on Ross Barkley. Why the fuck did we bring on Ross Barkley? We had him start against Everton in what was the biggest game for him, and he still didn't fucking turn up. Why would he turn up against their rivals? He came on and did nothing, and it was to be expected because every midfielder we had that started was better than him. So this for me, number one blame does go to Sarri, and before any one of you tries to say that I'm sorry, I've been sorry in all season and it's going to stay like that. But today he takes the blame. Today the players take the blame. But it's been the same old bullshit. And that's why I'm more pissed off. If we came here, we actually played well, maybe took one of our chances and still lost, I'd come out saying, yeah, it's Liverpool. They're the ones contending for the title. We're the ones contending for top four. I get that. They were going to be the better team and they lost. They were the better team and they won. Fair play. But when you do the same old shit that we see every single game, that's when you start to piss me off. Because this has been happening. How many months? How many months have we seen ourselves fall into the same trap? And we still got to go to Old Trafford in 2 weeks. Granted, United are playing kind of poorly. They're still racking up wins, though. And have you seen our away record against the top four? Hell, even against the top 12, I think we've only got 4 points against the whole top 12 away from home. Stats have been terrible this season. I get it's a transitional season, and I completely understand that. but we need Champions League football. Europa League, as soon as we get into that semis, it's going to be a very hard tie with either Frankfurt or either Benfica.
I can't just get past it.
I can't even... I think it'll be a bit tough, but if we don't win that semi-final, then we shouldn't even be thinking about Champions League football, to be honest. But that's our only really... That looks like our only real way forward. I mean, what are we going to do in the top four race? I mean, at home, we're all right. Away, we're fucking dreadful, though. I mean, the only thing that's saving us is United are playing poorly. That's another prick running in front of the camera. United are kind of saving us, looks like saving us, because they're playing poorly. Arsenal's away record is worse than ours for some reason. So there's still a chance, but we waste so many chances to rise above our top four rivals. And how many more chances are we going to get? That's what worries me. We take it to fucking Burnley next Monday. I mean, if we can't... If it's anything like when we played Burnley last season, then fuck top four, because it's not happening. But at least just fucking beat them.